Hi, and I welcome you to this lecture. In this lecture, I will talk about infrastructure of edge computing, and I will explain about important components of edge distributed infrastructure. In this lecture, I will also be introducing some important terms which are used in edge computing. Going forward, I will be using these terms in this course, so it's important for you to know these terms. The infrastructure of distributed computing and edge computing is more or less same. In other words, we can say edge computing is an extension of distributed computing. In distributed computing, we will just do computations in a distributed way without considering the distance between the source where the data originates and computation server. But in edge computing, we will just move the computation server as close as possible to the device from where the data is originating. In fact, we will move a part of the computation or full computation into the device itself. Now let's look into some of the components of edge distributed computing. The first component we are going to talk about is edge device. These are the devices which interacts with human being or environment to collect data, and these are the devices that acts as data source. Some of the examples of these devices could be a smartwatch or a self-driving car or a sensor in factory. On the huge volume of collected data, we perform computation and analytics, which will act as input for business intelligence. This will directly improve the business and quality of the service provided. These computations done on data are called workload. From now on, I will be addressing the computations done on data as workload. In edge computing, workload should be kept as close as possible to data source. So we should deploy possible workload in device. For this, we need to have a good computing capacity in edge device. Generally, an edge device can have 1 or 2 core CPUs and with 128 MB of cache memory, and it can have a local persistent storage of 1 GB. If device is so simple like sensor, then you need not have computing power in edge device. You have to make this decision based on your requirement. Next component we are going to discuss is edge server. Edge server will be located in same premises as edge device, just because of the fact that it should be very close to edge device to avoid latency. After deploying a part of the workload in edge device, the rest of the workload will be placed in edge servers. Since we are going to deploy a bit heavy workload in edge servers, it should have enough hardware configuration to run the workload. An edge server is typically constructed with an industrial PC standard, which can have 16 to 32 CPU cores, and its memory could be 16 GB. Then its local storage could be more than 100 GB. Next component we are going to see is edge gateway. Edge gateway will be similar to edge server in terms of hardware. Edge server and edge gateway will be located very close to edge device, and both are capable of hosting enterprise-grade application workloads for doing computations and analytics. The only difference between edge server and edge gateway is that edge gateway can perform network-related functions like protocol translations, network terminations, tunneling, maybe firewall protection or wireless connection to edge devices. So these are the things that will differ between an edge server and edge gateway. Since all of these three components can run edge application workload, these are generically referred as edge nodes. So when someone mentioned the term edge node, we should be knowing that they are referring to one of these three components. The last component we are going to discuss is centralized server. This server could be an on-premises server or it can be a cloud server. It is not required for the server to be in same location or closer to edge device because we will be sending only critical data to the server. Well, now you know about the basic infrastructure and components of edge computing. With this, I am concluding this lecture, and let's meet in my next lecture. Thank you.